ever grateful to you. Thank you for all that you have done for SAR, for your students. We're going to miss you a lot. You will always be a part of the SAR family.
First, I want to thank everybody who put all this together. This is something that I'll remember for the rest of my life. Looking around all the tables and see all the athletes there, and all the students and friends. I won't forget your faces. I won't forget your names, but I won't forget your faces. I came here in 2004. When I came here, there were about 5 teams total. Now, we're up to 25 teams. I remember when we started, students like you would come to me and say, well, let's have this kind of team. Let's have a JV team. Let's have this, another soccer team. And I would go to Rabbi Hochstock, and I would tell him that the students are asking me this. He says, well, if we have an interest, and enough people who want to participate, then let's do it. And that's how really the teams developed from 5 to 25 in relatively short period of time. Since we began, I wanted to figure out, we have bands all over the place, but since we started the school, we have 36 championship banners. And that's a credit to you. I consider myself very, very fortunate. I worked in a school at SAR with students like yourselves that always made me feel good to be around. It was a great environment to work in, and I have lasting memories from the whole, just people being around, little athletic moments. Moments that had nothing to do with athletics in the school. It was always a pleasure. It made it so easy for me to work with you guys. Of course, you're just so nice to be able to work with. And now I guess it's time for me to, retire. I started out my first teaching job. Began in 1968. If you add it up, it's 50 years ago. Yeah, I'm old. I love 50 years, this last 14 years that I've been in SAR, and what a way to kind of finish my career. Could be better than that. So I was thinking, what kind of parting moment what can I tell you that might be that you could, something that you can gain from what I say? Well, we always talk about winning. We always talk about winning. Winning and then all. I don't win, it's so good. And, winning could be in a lot of different ways. So I just want to read a paragraph that I think will describe what I'm talking about. Have you heard the story that came out of the Seattle Special Olympics? For the 100-yard dash, there were 9 contestants. all of them so-called physically or mentally disabled. All nine of them assembled at the starting line, and at the sound of the gun, they took off. But one little boy didn't get very far. He stumbled and fell and heard his knee and began to cry. The other eight children heard the boy crying. They slowed down, turned around, and ran back to him. Every one of them ran back to him. One little girl with Down syndrome bent down and kissed the boy and said, "This will make it better." The little boy got up, and he and the rest of the runners linked their arms together and joyfully walked to the finish line. They all finished the race at the same time, and when they did, everyone in the stadium stood up and clapped and whistled and cheered for a long, long time. People who were there are still telling the story with obvious delight, and you know why? Because deep down, we know what matters in this life is more than winning for ourselves. What really matters is helping others win too. Even if it means slowing down and changing our course now and then. I want to thank you all for everything. It's been an honor and a pleasure to be here.